A very good morning, dear children. I hope you all are fine and safe with your family. Students, today in history, we will begin with a new lesson, that is lesson number 7, and name of the lesson is The Administration of the Swaraj. Shivaji Maharaj founded Swaraj. He had himself crowned. After the coronation, Maharaj accomplished Dakshin Digvijay, the conquest of the south. We shall get some information about it in this chapter. The Swaraj, comprising large areas of Nasik, Pune, Satara, Sangli, Kolhapur, Sindhudurg, Ratnagiri, Raigarh, Thane district in Maharashtra and parts of Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. To ensure the smooth management of the affairs of the Swaraj and people's welfare, Shivaji Maharaj set up an efficient administration. So what happened, students? To see the smooth management of the affairs of the Swaraj, that means everything should manage in a very smooth way. What Maharaj did? He set up an efficient administration. Ashta Pradhan Mandal, that is also called as Council of 8 Ministers. At the time of his coronation, Shivaji Maharaj appointed a council of 8 ministers. The administration was divided into 8 different departments. A head was appointed for each department. That means for each and every department there was a head. These 8 heads of department constituted the Ashta Pradhan Mandal. Maharaj alone had the power to appoint a minister or to remove him from his position. The ministers were answerable to Maharaj for the administration of their respective departments. Shivaji Maharaj selected the council on the basis of their merit and achievements. He did not give them jagirs, vatans or gifts of fears. They were paid a good salary instead. Name of the ministers, designations and work. First one is Moro Trimbak Pingle. His designation was Pradhan and his work was running the administration and making arrangements for the conquered territories. That means what all territories which were conquered, his duty was to see that everything is working smoothly or not. That means to run the administration. Second one, Ramchandra Neelkanth Muzumdar. His designation was as Amatya and his work was keeping the accounts of the state. Third, Annaji Dato. His designation was as Sachiv and his work was preparing royal edicts. Next, Dattaji Trimbak Vaknis. His designation was as Mantri and his job was to do the correspondence. Fifth, Hambi Rao Mohite. His designation was as Senapati and his work was organization of the army and protection of the kingdom. Next, Ramchandra Trimbak Dabi. His designation was as Sumant and his work was foreign relations. Seventh, Niraji Ravaji. His designation was as Nyayadish and his work was dispensing justice. And last one, that is Moreshwar Pandit Rao. His designation was Pandit Rao and his work was looking after religious matters. So here there was a detailed description about Ashtapradhan Mandal of Shivaji Maharaj. The policy regarding agriculture. Agriculture was the main occupation in villages. So what was the main occupation in villages? Agriculture. Annaji Datto was entrusted the responsibility of organizing land revenue system. Officers were warned not to collect more revenue than the amount that was fixed. Officers were not allowed to collect more revenue. Only that much amount was being told to collect, whatever amount was being fixed. He encouraged the peasants to bring uncultivated land under cultivation. Remission in the land revenue. Remission means what, students? Some sort of a relaxation, or you can also say cancellation. Remission in the land revenue was granted when there was excess rainfall, famine, or devastation caused by an enemy's army. So only when there was, it means only if there was excess rainfall, famine, or devastation which was caused by an enemy's army, that time only remission in the land revenue was granted. Officers were instructed to provide bullocks, ploughs, and good quality seeds. So what officers were instructed? That they were supposed to provide bullocks, ploughs, and good quality seeds. Next we come to village economy. Agriculture was the backbone of self-sufficient rural economy. Artisans produced goods and rendered service to the local people. So what artisans used to do? They used to produce goods and they used to render service to the local people. So in return, what farmers used to do? The farmers in return gave a share of agriculture produce, that is baluta, to the artisans. So what farmers used to do? They used to give a share of agriculture produce, which is called as baluta. To whom they used to give? They used to give it to artisans. So this was the village economy of those times. Trade and business. Maharaj knew that a kingdom does not prosper without an increase in trade. Okay, so if a kingdom has to prosper, so that time trade has to increase. Okay, why it is to be increased? Because trade brings wealth. Merchants bring noble goods as also certain necessities into a kingdom. Goods bring available in plenty. Trade prospers, adding to wealth. The view that Maharaj took of merchants is seen in the Ajintya Patra, where merchants are described as follows. Merchants are the ornaments of the kingdom and glory of the king. Okay, students, so what it means? The view that Maharaj took of merchants is seen in Ajintya Patra, where what is written in that? It is written as merchants are the ornaments of the kingdom. So who have been described as ornaments of the kingdom? Merchants, and also glory of the king. Maharaj charged heavy duty on imported goods, thus protecting the local industry such as salt industry in the Konkan. So what Maharaj used to do? He used to charge heavy duty. On what he used to charge heavy duty? On imported goods. So that, thus protecting the local industry like salt industry in Konkan. He protected the salt industry in Konkan. At that time, traders imported salt from the Portuguese territory and sold in Swaraj. That affected the local trade in Konkan areas. So, Maharaj charged heavy duty on the salt imported into Swaraj from the Portuguese territory. The intention was that the salt imported from Portuguese territory would then cost more, and as a result, its import would decrease and the sale of the local salt would increase. So let's recap, student, what we have learned in our this video. To ensure the smooth management of the affairs of the Swaraj and people's welfare, Shivaji Maharaj set up an efficient administration. We have also learned in detail about Asht Pradhan Mandal, that is Council of 8 Ministers. Then we have learned about policy regarding agriculture. We have also learned in detail about village economy, how agriculture was the backbone of self-sufficient rural economy, and how artisans produce goods and render services to local people. After that, we have learned about trade and business. In this, we have seen how Maharaj knew that kingdom does not prosper without an increase in trade, because trade brings wealth. We have also seen how Maharaj charged heavy duty on imported goods, thus protecting the local industry such as salt industry in the Konkan. So here we come to an end of this video, students. I hope it must be cleared with everyone. If there is any doubt, I request you all to again go through the video. Till the time, stay safe and thank you so much. A very good morning, dear children. I hope you all are fine and safe with your family. Students, today in history, we will be continuing with our same lesson, that is lesson number 7. And name of the lesson, the administration of the Swaraj. Before we move with this video, let us recall what we have learned in our last video. We have learned in detail about Asht Pradhan Mandal, in which we have learned about administration was divided into 8 departments, and Shivaji Maharaj appointed a council of 8 ministers. A head was appointed for each department. Then we have learned about policy regarding agriculture. In this, we have learned about agriculture was the main occupation in villages. Annaji Dato was entrusted the responsibility of organizing land revenue system. Then we have learned about village economy. In this, we have learned agriculture was the backbone of self-sufficient rural economy. Artisans produce goods and rendered service to the local people. And then we have learned about trade and business. In this, we have learned about Maharaj knew that kingdom does not prosper without an increase in trade, because trade brings wealth. We have also seen Maharaj charged heavy duty on imported goods, thus protecting the local industry such as salt industry in the Konkan. Now we will be learning about the military organization. Infantry and cavalry were the two main divisions of the army. Havaldars and Zumledars were the officers, and Sarnobats was the highest officer of the army. So who were the highest officers of the army? Sarnobat. And Havaldars and Zumledar were the officers. Shiledars and Bargis were the cavalry men, and Sarnobat was the highest officer of the cavalry. Netoji Palkar, Pratap Rao Guzar, Hambirao Mohite were some of the famous Sarnobats of the cavalry. सो हु वर फेमस सर नोबल्स ऑफ द कैवलरी? नेतोजी पालकर, प्रताप राव गुजर एंड हम्बीराव मोहिते वर सम ऑफ द फेमस सर नोबल्स ऑफ द कैवलरी. सो दिस वॉज समथिंग अबाउट द मिलिट्री ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Next, we come to intelligence department. Intelligence department collected precise and timely information about the movements of the enemy and submitted it to Maharaj. So, what was the duty of intelligence department? They were collecting precise and timely information. About whom they were doing all this? About the movements of the enemy. And after collecting all this information, they were submitting it to Maharaj. Okay, so that was the job of intelligence department. Bahirji Nayak, the head of the intelligence department, gave accurate and detailed information about Surat before raid. Okay, so who was the head of intelligence department? Bahirji Nayak. So what he did? He gave accurate and detailed information about Surat before raid. Forts. Forts were of great importance in the medieval age. Forts helped to keep an eye on the surrounding areas, protecting people against foreign invasion, and helped in stocking food grains, ammunition, etc. So, what forts, how it was been helped to everyone? Because it kept an eye on the surrounding area, it protected people against foreign invasion, and also it helped in stocking food grains, ammunition, etc. There were about 300 forts in the Swaraj. So, how many forts were there in the Swaraj? Round about 300. Kiledar, Subnis and Karkhanis were the officials on every fort. So in each and every fort there were Kiledar, there were Subnis and there were Karkhanis. Next. Yes students, you can see the image. You can see Pratapgarh fort, you can see Pavangarh fort and you can see Rajgarh. Okay students, so the importance of forts in the foundation of Swaraj is well stated in Ajanya Patra. This kingdom was created by late revered and exalted majesty forts alone. Now moving ahead with sea forts. Maharaj knew the importance of sea forts. He built Sindhudurg fort at Malvan on the west coast. It is an excellent sea fort. To give strength to the construction of the fort, 5 khandis of lead was poured into its foundation. He built Padmadurga near Rajapur to overshadow the Rajapur of the Siddhi. Next, we move to Navy. To curb the activities of the enemies and to protect the west coast, Maharaj raised a Navy. So, why Maharaj raised a Navy? To curb. Curb means for students to keep an eye. We can also call this to check. Okay. So, to check the activities of the enemies and also to protect the west coast, Maharaj raised a navy. He realized that to control the sea, it is necessary to have a navy. So what he realized that if we want to control the sea, it is necessary that we should have a navy. Navy consisted of 400 ships like Gurup, Galbat and Pal battleships. Ships were built at the creek of Kalyan, Bhiwandi, Vijayadurga and Malvan. Mainam Bhandari and Daulat Khan were the chief naval commanders. So who were chief naval commanders? Mainam Bhandari and Daulat Khan. Concern for the welfare of his subjects. The main objective of Maharaj was to make his subjects independent. Subjects means what, students? It is nothing but it is people. So what was the main objective of Maharaj? Main objective of Maharaj was only to make his people independent. He was aware that for the subjects to enjoy freedom, disciplined administrations, comprehensive care of people, and protection of conquered territory was necessary. So how his people can be independent? What things to be kept in mind? There should be disciplined administration, comprehensive care of people, and protection of conquered territory was necessary. Then only people can enjoy freedom. Maharaj was a watchful administrator who cared for his people's welfare. Okay, students? So, this is what which has been clearly seen in this lesson, which is called as administration of the Swaraj. I hope, students, it must be till here clear with everyone. So, let's recap, students, what we have learned in our this video. We have learned in detail about military organization, in which we have learned about infantry and cavalry were the two main divisions of the army. We have also learned about Havaldars and Jubledars were the officers, and Sarnobats were the highest officer of the army. We have also learned about intelligence department, in which Bahirji Nayak, the head of intelligence department, gave accurate and detailed information about Surat before raid. Then we have learned in detail about forts. How forts were of great importance in the medieval age. Then we have learned about sea forts, in which how Shivaji Maharaj knew the importance of sea forts, how he built Sindhudurga fort at Malvan on the west coast, he built Padmadurga near Rajapur to overshadow the Rajapur of the city. Then we have learned about navy, in which we have learned about to curb the activities of the enemies and to protect the west coast, Maharaj raised a navy. And at the end, we have learned in detail about concern for the welfare of his subjects. So, here we have learned the main objective of Maharaj was to make his subject independent. Maharaj was a watchful administrator who cared for his people's welfare. So, here students, we have completed this lesson. I hope it must be cleared with everyone. If any doubt is there, I request you all to again watch the video. Till the time, stay safe and thank you so much.